Now, rotating these rings, well, the orientation of the ring gaps. Once again, if you Google this, you're going to get 100 different ways to do it. Obviously, this is the skirt that's going to take the most abuse, so I would say don't put any ring gaps in this section here. So you can put the top ring 45 degrees, not over this. So I would say put it here, also not over the skirt. Then you can put this one all the way here, or you can put it here. I don't know, I put it there because, you know, it's longer distance to travel. If any air is leaking through here, it must travel all the way this way before it can go into your sump. Then again, that's just a theory. One thing that annoys me is this. I go to the spare shop and ask them for rings for a 1.5 on the Civic. And then, you know, coincidentally, I also ask them for a ring compressor. And then they sell me this. Probably to install rings for trucks. And there it is. It's not easy, but it does work with this massive truck ring squeezer. Obviously, you want to make sure it's seated all the way. You see, it has these small tabs that sit on the sleeves. Make sure it's seated all the way, that it's not like coned up here. And then don't force it. If it doesn't want to go in, then push it. Secondly, I rotate the crank, so when I do this one, I will rotate the crank so that you don't damage the big end journal. There we go, all the pistons are in. Now I'm going to flip it around. Pistons should not be able to fall out. So we can bolt down the rods. because it's a few days later. We made some progress. I got an oil pump, cleaned it up nicely. Looks to be in good shape. I don't know if my test is worth anything, but what I did is I poured oil in here and then to see if it would leak past the, basically the pump gears. Because in my logic, if the pump gears are worn out and you put oil in here, it might leak past them. I left it in there for about 10 minutes, but the oil didn't leak through. It's kind of just stayed in here. So I took the oil out. Actually, I turned it to pump the oil out to the other side. And then I used basically penetrating oil. And I sprayed that in there and did the same test. Because obviously the oil's cold, so the viscosity is quite high. So I sprayed that in there because this has like almost no viscosity at all. And then see if that would leak through. Now that did leak through, but not very quickly. So you'd spray it there and it would sit there and it would, the level would slowly drop. And eventually it would like drop down and come out the other side. So I think that's probably normal for penetrating oil to come through. I mean, this is not a sealed surface. It's just supposed to pump oil. And obviously the oil is much thicker than the penetrating oil. So yeah, with that test done, I'm gonna approve this for use. I mean, all this stuff here is basically reused. We're using this water pump. It's an original Honda one, so it's probably 20 years old, but I mean, the bearing sounds good. This was on this engine, so I know it didn't leak. Didn't have any problems. Same with this bearing. This is a replaced one, because I'm pretty sure that's not a Honda original manufacturing logo. This also sounds good. This is probably replaced not too long ago. So yeah, we're gonna go with that. We do still need the pulley. I've been running into some trouble finding that. We have this end cap on. So yeah, I believe we now have everything we need. Perfect. The battery died yesterday, but we got the, let's say, the water neck, the breather box. Also on this side we got the oil pump on. You guys can see it's nice and sealed up all around. So now I finally have a pulley I'm gonna use. Actually bought a new one, so this is the right one, but this one is damaged. This is a new one, but it doesn't work. So if you guys check the level on it again, see how much difference there are between where the belt should run. Now weirdly this one is an intermediate one, it's in between those two, so I'm just going to use this one and then perhaps just space the alternator out a bit. Okay, so here's the gasket. This is a three layer steel gasket. And you should take care not to put this on the wrong way around, even though I'm not sure if you even can put it the wrong way around. The reason why I say that is it is the wrong way around now, but if you look, you'll see that this doesn't line up now, nor does the one on this side. It's almost like these two holes are further out than the front ones. So yeah, this is the way it goes. And now you can see all these holes line up perfectly. Okay, so we ran into a little issue. So we can see all these head bolts just sitting here at the same height. I haven't started turning them. Then if we go to the back here, You can see this one sits lower than the other ones by about, let's say, 8 millimeters. Now, on the original head, the seat where this one sits is actually lower as well, meaning even though it sits lower, it bolts down lower, so it's fine. However, on this P08 VTEC head, these ones are all the same. So this one will have about 8 mil less thread to bolt onto. And I'm wondering if that is going to be an issue or not. I'm kind of thinking this will still be fine. But I checked it with this little children's toy, and there you can see the difference. If I check this one, you see it's on the bolt and on the washer. If you go back to this one, it's on the washer and it's like at the top of the bolt ish and then so this section is about 8 to 10 mils. Now if you look at this one is terrible because now all this VTEC stuff is here. Obviously you have this VTEC oil feed going here. So now this seat just lifted, but in the block it's still the same. So it's sitting at the same height as that one. You see these two bolts are at the same height, but this one's seat is much higher. So that means this one will only have about this one will only have about 15 millimeters of thread actually gripping, which is bad because that's not gonna work. Okay, so we took a step back. This is the one I had, but you guys can see this, the thread on this one is very, very damaged. Also doesn't turn easily. Like, I turned it until it got stuck and then I immediately stopped because I don't want to damage the threads in the block. So I went to a friend of mine, got another one. This one's threads is very good shape. So yeah, now we basically have a longer stud for here. So what I'm going to do is just cut the bottom off because it's slightly too long. If you look at these two studs, this is the standard one, and this is the extra one, or this is the extra long one, and you can see it's a tiny bit too long. I'd say I'm going to cut right just the edge of this off so it doesn't bottom out in the block. Okay, so we're back to where we were. All the bolts are sitting in their places, all at the same height. On this one, I have the super long bolt in here. I have one washer just to space the bolt out a bit, so I decided not to cut the bottom of it off. I did measure how deep the hole is and how long the bolt is, and it is almost 1 centimeter deeper than what the bolt is, about 8 millimeters, so I think that will be just fine.